Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, we bless God on this day, the day after we celebrated the birth of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus. Glory to God. We should be so excited. We should be so grateful for his mercy. He is all powerful. He is amazing. Glory to God. He is God. Hallelujah. And we just want to bless him on this day. We thank him for waking us up this morning and beginning our day with brand new mercies. Glory to God. First, before we even get into it, like I always do, we want to welcome you to Midday Glory. It's our last meeting of 2018. It's the last Wednesday of 2018. It's the last month of the year. Glory to God. I'm Reverend Gwendolyn Dixon, and I'll be your host for the next 20 minutes. Glory to God. I've heard people say it's a cliche, but let me tell you something. Cliche or not, Jesus is the reason for this season. Amen. Therefore, we should praise him with everything that's in us. Glory to God. You know, I told you on last week that I wanted to share with you why I celebrate Jesus. We've heard so much things of what we do, should do, what we should not do, this, that, and the other. But last week, as I was thinking about why I should celebrate Jesus, Jesus said to me, it ain't you, it's all believers. Why we should celebrate him. Why we should celebrate Christmas, I should say. So I'm the type of person that I've heard so much stuff and so many things being said from the pulpit, this, that, and the other. I like to stay strictly with the Word of God. So what I'm about to give you and the reason for celebrating Jesus is strictly from the Word of God. I don't like to speak from my flesh. I want to make sure that I'm hearing from God. I want to hear God's voice speaking to me and let him instruct me on what to say. It's so important to me as we live in this world that we're living in where we're beginning to change because man is changing and all this kind of stuff. I can't be bothered with that. I've got to make sure that I stay in the Word of God. God is so awesome. And, you know, just as we celebrate our birthdays, and we hear people say, I celebrate the whole month. Well, let me tell you, as excited as we get about celebrating our birthdays, we should be the same way in celebrating Jesus, not just the whole month, but the entire year. Glory to God. Christmas should have been a glorious high time for especially believers. And it's not about the traditional world way, but it's about thinking about the reason for the season because he is our King of Kings. He is our Lord of Lords. He is the master of this universe. Glory to God. So we are about to share with you unique ways or awesome ways and celebrating the birth of Jesus and why we should celebrate his birth, why we should celebrate Christmas, glory to God. So we first want to start off with Jesus is the Word of God. John, in chapter 1 of John, verses 1 and 2, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. You see, Jesus was there with the Father in the very beginning, before the world was made and before sin even entered in. Genesis 1:26 says, God speaks of creating a man. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over the cattle and over all the earth and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. When Jesus became flesh, he brought to us everything that God was and is, glory to God. Salvation became flesh. Healing became flesh. Love became flesh. Peace became flesh. The Word became flesh so it could touch our flesh. It could save us. It could heal us. It could redeem us, glory to God. So as we look at what Jesus came and did, we will see love manifested in every way, glory to God. When he forgave the sinner, love became flesh. When he fed the multitude, provisions became flesh. When he touched the sick, healing became flesh, glory to God. And then the second thing is that Jesus is Emmanuel. And Isaiah 7:14 says, therefore the Lord himself shall give you a son. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son and shall call his name Emmanuel. Matthew even refers back to this verse as evidence of a prophecy fulfilled through the birth of Jesus. And Matthew 2:23 says, "And he came and dwelt in a city called Nazareth, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophets. He shall be called a Nazarene." Glory to God. We sing his name, Emmanuel. But what does that word or that name really mean? The definition of Emmanuel is God with us. Isaiah spoke about how God would one day remove all that separated us from his love and his power and friends. But reading that, we all wondered at some point how that could be possible for us, for a world that's so full of sin. But now we know, as we have studied and we have become having a relationship with God, that all things are possible with Christ Jesus. Emmanuel, Jesus Christ, is the answer. And one name, we are able to understand that Jesus is the way to be with God. He did everything needed to remove the guilt and the stain of sin from our lives. Sin caused man to be separated from God. Jesus came. He took away the sin of the world, and by doing so, he took away the very thing that separated us from God. Hallelujah. Now he's with us forever. Glory to God. Nothing can ever, ever separate us from his love, because nothing can separate us from him. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm getting excited in here, Lord God, because he is so good, and I love the Lord so much. The separation from God, hallelujah, has been removed. No matter how many times we failed, glory to God, he will never leave us nor forsake us. Rest in the powerful truth today that he is with us. He is Emmanuel. Glory to God. I get so excited about this, because we who were once separated from the light and love of God will never, ever be separated again. Jesus is the one who showed us that God not only wants to be with us, but he will do anything and everything to make it happen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And the next reason that we should celebrate Christmas is Jesus is our deliverer. And in Romans 11:26-27, it says, "So all Israel shall be saved. And it is written, this shall come out of Zion, the deliverer, and shall turn away ungodliness from Jacob. For this is my covenant with them, when I shall take away their sins." See, when we are saved, we experience an ongoing process of redemption and deliverance that works miracles every day of our lives. Glory to God. And don't nobody have that power but Jesus. Glory to God. And then Jesus is the Lamb of God. John 1:29 says, "The next day John saw Jesus coming towards him. Behold," he said, "behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." And then Jesus is the bridegroom. In Revelation 19:7, it says, "Let us rejoice and be glad and give the glory to God, for the marriage of the Lamb has come, and his bride has made herself ready." Glory to God. What is more exciting to an engaged couple than their loved ones at the arrival of the wedding day? As we've planned and prepared all of this time, the moment the groom gets to see his bride for the very first time, she's adorned in all her glory, glory to God, and then the reading of the wedding vows, and then their first embrace as one. It brings such a flood of love and completion that often even the groom shares a tear, and even the bride too sometimes. The purity and joy of the union is so powerful. Jesus is our bridegroom. With us as his bride. This imaginary is a perfect picture of the anticipation and the eagerness that Jesus has for us, his bride. Jesus longs for us to come to him and to be united with him. He is not distant. He's not difficult. He's not unkind. He never counts our thoughts, glory to God, and he will never focus on our mistakes. Jesus is waiting for us to see the love that he has for us. When Jesus promised that nothing would ever separate us from the love of God, it wasn't based on our ability to earn it. It was based on the power of his love to break through every wall, every chain, every obstacle, glory to God. The thirst of love stops at nothing, glory. The fire of love stops at nothing, glory to God. It suits everything before it. Flood waters cannot drown love, glory to God. Torments of rain cannot put it out. That love is from Christ. Jesus' love towards us is complete and is utterly inquenchable love. He is the chief cornerstone. He is the head of all things, glory to God. He is our companion. He is the bread of life. He is the great I am. He is our shepherd. We are blessed and we are highly favored. Jesus is everything that we need, glory to God. And that is why we should celebrate Christmas. We should celebrate Jesus, glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us pray. Oh, hallelujah. Bless your name, glory to God. Father God, we thank you that you are the King of Kings, hallelujah. You are the Lord of Lords. You are the Master, glory to God. You are the ruler of this universe, God. You are the Almighty God, hallelujah. God, angels bow before you, heaven and earth, Almighty God. Adore you, glory to God. We thank you, Almighty God, hallelujah, for this day, for your birth, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that we celebrate this month, oh Lord God, for the birth of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord God, that every year, Lord God, as your birthday comes around, God, the month that we celebrate, we know that we have grown in you spiritually, Lord God, and we celebrate you all the more. We say, happy birthday, Jesus, glory to God. We thank you, Almighty God, for the scriptures, oh Lord God, that is written, Lord God. We thank you, oh Lord God, that you loved us enough, oh God, to send a Messiah, to send a Savior, a Counselor, Almighty God, to come and take away the sins of this world, Lord God. We thank you, Almighty God, for taking away our sins, for taking away our mistakes, for taking away our faults that you do not even see them, glory to God. We exalt your name today, Lord God. We extol your name, Lord God. We bow, Almighty God, in reference to our holy God, hallelujah, a Lord God without sin, without spot, or without wrinkle, Lord God. You are worthy to be praised, God. We salute you on this day, Almighty God. We appreciate, Almighty God, all that you have done, Lord God, all that you are still doing for us in our lives, Lord God. We are determined, oh Lord God, to see your goodness, Lord God. Even in a dark, clouded world that we are living in, God, which, Father God, we look beyond circumstances, hallelujah. We look beyond, Father God, the things that are going on in the White House, Lord God. We look beyond, oh God, the things that are changing, Father God, by man's standards, Lord God. Glory to God. We lean and depend on you, Almighty God. We will not lean, oh God, into our own understanding, but we acknowledge you, Almighty God, in everything that we do, Lord God, hallelujah. We put you first, God. We seek you with our whole heart, Lord God. We know, God, that we cannot, Father God, depend on ourselves, hallelujah. We know that you are the Christ. You are the Son of the living God, hallelujah. You are the sent one, hallelujah. You are the one, Almighty God, who took away every one of our sins, oh, glory to God. Thank you, Lord God, that you cleanse us, hallelujah. You purge us, Lord God. You've given us a mind, Almighty God, to serve you, Lord God. And you have made us, Almighty God, whiter than sports. No, Lord God. Oh, we thank you, Lord God. We thank you for a mind, oh God, hallelujah, the mind of Christ that have learned to put all of our trust in you, Lord God, to cast all of our cares upon you, Lord God, and leave them right there with you, Lord God. We will not allow fear, Almighty God, to grip us, Lord God. We will not allow anxiety to control us, Lord God. We will not allow anger to consume us, Lord God. We will not allow the cares of this world, oh Lord God, to, Father God, take over us, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God, hallelujah. We will delight in you, Almighty God, hallelujah. We will meditate on your word day and night, Almighty God. You, Father God, we will be the righteous man, hallelujah, whose delight is in you, Almighty God, hallelujah, God. You are the light of this world, glory to God, hallelujah. And we know, God, that if we just stay with you, God, the light within you, God, will shine towards us, God, and we can be a testimony, Father God, to those who do not know you in the pardon of their sins. We could be a testimony, oh God, to those who are hurting, God. We could be a testimony, oh God, who those who know you, Lord God, but Father God, they've lost their trust because of something that has happened, Lord God. We want to be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, Lord God, that we can be instruments, Almighty God, that you will use of us, Lord God, hallelujah. Father God, we speak, Father God, the word of God today, God. We prophesy in the name of Jesus, Father God, over your word, Father God. You said that we should prosper and be in good health, Lord God, and as we are about to enter into another year, Lord God, we speak nothing but the word over our lives, Lord God. You said all we have to do is ask, Father God, in your name, Lord God, and you would do it for us, Lord God, as we live according to your holy word, Lord God. We know, God, that our lives would be prosperous in the name of Jesus, God. We speak your word over our lives, Lord God. We love you, Lord God, and we will keep your commandments, Lord God. Your word, oh God, does not change, hallelujah. You do not change. You are the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore, Lord God. For you, Almighty God, we are constantly watching. Father God, you are constantly, constantly watching us because you are omnipresent, Lord God. You are our shield of protection. You are our high tower, Lord God. Your eyes, Almighty God, are everywhere at the same time. What a mighty God, hallelujah. Oh, the Holy Spirit teaches us the direction, oh God, in which we should go, Lord God. You direct our path, Lord God, hallelujah. You are just so amazing, Lord God. You are so astounding, Lord God. Lord God, we thank you for your anointing, oh God, that we know, God, that falls afresh on us every single day, Lord God. You are such a compassionate God, hallelujah. You are so devoted and so dependable. You're so trustworthy, Lord God. Lord God, we just want you to know that we appreciate you, God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have empowered us with your Holy Spirit, Lord God, so we cannot do what our flesh desires to do anymore, God, hallelujah. Thank you, Almighty God, for forgiving us. Thank you for freeing us, God. Thank you for loosening us, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, that God, that you have the power to look beyond our faults and see our needs, Lord God. You know everything that there is to know about us, but yet you still love us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Help us, Almighty God, to love one another. For you are holy, Lord God. You are a healer, Lord God. Hallelujah. And Father God, even though sometimes we don't know it, we believe that you are healing us right now in the name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah. Lord God, we release in the name of Jesus, God, blessings over our parents, Lord God, blessings over our grandparents, Lord God, blessings over our siblings, Lord God, blessings over our aunts and our uncles, Lord God, blessings over our cousins, Lord God, blessings over every marriage in the mighty name of Jesus, God, blessings over our children, our grandchildren, oh God, blessings over in-laws, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God, we release blessings over our church families, oh God, blessings over our neighbors, blessings, oh God, over associates in the name of Jesus, God, we release blessings, Father God, even over our enemies, oh God, because you said, Lord God, that we should love our enemies, God, we should bless them that curse us and do good to those that despitefully use us and hate us, Lord God, those who, God, Father God, who persecute us falsely for your name's sake, glory to God, you said that we shall love them. So we pray for our enemies, God. We pray, God, we will line up with your word, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, that we will be those soldiers, God, that will stand on the front line of the battlefield, not afraid, because we know, God, that you are with us in the name of Jesus, God. We pray for all situations that are going on in everybody's life today in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Lord God, we release your powerful anointing and your blessing, God, over the homeless, God. We release it over our senior citizens in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We release blessings, Almighty God, over the family that is struggling, Father God, that can't keep heat in their home, God. They don't have the funds, oh God. They can't keep food on their table, God. But we thank you that they trust you, Father God, because they know that you will supply all of their needs according to your riches and glory, Lord God. You are out there provider, Lord God. We, Father God, continue to bless that family, oh God, that praises you in spite of that they've learned that you are the Christ, and besides you, there is no one else, Lord God. Father God, we thank you, Father God, that we've learned to delight in you, Lord God. Hallelujah. We know that nothing but joy, nothing but peace, oh God, comes only from you, Almighty God. Hallelujah. We just bless you today, Lord God. You are more than enough, glory to God. Hallelujah. In spite of all the news, oh God, that we are hearing, in spite of the government being shut down right now, God, in spite of all the sexual misconduct, Father God, by top leaders and tax players and all of these things that are going on, God, everything that is going on in the White House, in Congress, in the Senate, Lord God, in spite of the bills being increased, God, appliances breaking out, all these things that people are going through, that we are all going through, God, in spite of everything, God, we know that you are still in control, glory to God, and we rest in it, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. All of the killing, Lord God, all of the freak accidents of death, all of these people who died, Father God, and especially as I pray today, God, I pray for those people that were held hostages in jail, Father God, for a crime that they did not pay. And after 20, 30 years, they've been set free, God. I pray, God, that you would open doors for them like never before, God. I pray, God, that they will be an instrument that you will use, God, that they will give their testimony, Lord God. They will show how they lean and depend on you through all of the agony in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, Almighty God, for the children today, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, especially a lot of children are home alone today because their parents have had to go to work, Lord God. We pray for your shield of protection over them in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We know, God, that you will help, Father God, in any way that you can, God. We thank you, Lord God, because we love to pray, God. You said that we should pray without ceasing, Father God. We pray for soldiers. We pray for the soldiers' families, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God. Pray for those who have lost loved ones, Father God, during this a season, Lord God, especially those that were unexpected, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, for the police officer that was killed, Father God, out in California, left a young child, Lord God, on Christmas Eve, oh God. We pray, Almighty God, for all of those that are struggling, Lord God, through times of this year, Father God, because they have pain and sorrow going on in their hearts, Lord God. We pray, God, for single parents, oh God. We pray for marriages today, Lord God. Marriage, Father God, that marriages that are struggling, especially Christian marriages, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, for pastors and ministers, Father God, that are separating, divorcing, God. We speak, Father God, life in marriages in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, Almighty God, for all of those who lost their homes and fires all over the world, Lord God. We pray for those, oh God, who have suicidal thoughts, God, those who are lonely, Lord God, those who feel that they cannot go any farther, Lord God, because their burdens are just too heavy, Lord God. Teach them, Almighty God, to cast their burdens over to you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Relinquish everything, glory to God, because nothing belongs to us, God. You are the God that is more than enough. You can do the impossible, Lord God. You can move mountains. You said in your word, as for us as believers, to delight ourselves in you, Lord God. We are not ashamed, oh God, of the gospel of Christ, Lord God. We will delight, oh Father God, in you, Lord God. We will praise you wherever we are, Lord God. We will worship you in spirit and in truth, Lord God. You bring forth strength, God. You bring forth encouragement, glory to God. And we just speak victory in the mighty name of Jesus. You are our rock, Lord God. We put all of our trust in you. There is nothing impossible for you, Almighty God. We bless you. We honor you, Lord God, and we give you all the glory and all the praise in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus. And we say amen, amen, and amen. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year for When Christmas Speak Talk Radio. Our founder is the Pastor Ray Rose. Midday Glory is your host for this hour, this 20 minutes. We want to thank you. We bless you. And we thank you that you are thinking positive for the brand new year 2019. And we'll see you next year. Glory to God. Bye-bye.